Hi there, welcome to Villa Molino Cookery Club. Today, on this lovely chilly winter's day, it's the 2nd of December, but what a beautiful day, ladies and gentlemen. Look at the beautiful sunshine. We're out here in the countryside at our lovely cookery school, Villa Molino Cookery Club. We're gonna make a lovely recipe today, which is gonna warm you up on those cold winter nights. It's actually a recipe that I got from a friend of mine who runs a restaurant in Ronda in Spain. Now, this is a Michelin star restaurant, but a Michelin star not for fancy schmancy cuisine with foam and puke and this and that. This is a Michelin star restaurant that does traditional Spanish cuisine. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this restaurant called Tragata in Ronda, and I'll have you know that Ronda in Spain has 3 Michelin star restaurants in a tiny little town near to Seville, near to Jerez. Lovely, lovely little town, Ronda in Spain, has 3 Michelin star restaurants: Tragata, Bardal, and Albacaro. Go to Ronda, go and see. Right, this is a recipe called Rabo de Toro con Patate. Yes, oxtail stew with potatoes. So I'm gonna do puree potatoes, they're cooking on the side. We're gonna do oxtail stew. Fantastic Michelin cuisine. Today, for you, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Michelin cuisine. So we're gonna start. We've got our ingredients. We've got oxtail, we've got seasoned flour, onions, carrots, celery, leeks, garlic, thyme. I've got plenty of thyme for you. We've got some of my secret powder. When I cook with meat, I make a stew. I've got ground caraway seed. Just a tiny bit, gives it a nice punch. We've got beef stock. We've got brandy, Remy Martin, VSOP, very nice, red wine. Actually, Campo Viejo Rioja from Spain. Nice wine, Spanish red wine to go with a Spanish oxtail. So now what we're gonna do, I'm gonna cut away in bits and pieces because we need extra oil for this. Don't worry, because the surplus oil, we're gonna chuck it away. So we've got the seasoned salt here, seasoned flour, salt, pepper. Slightly dust the oxtail in the seasoned flour, put it in the oil to seal, right? That's sizzling up nicely. I can see it's starting to sizzle. Seasoned flour, oil, whack it all in. Don't do this with olive oil at the moment. Don't do this with olive oil. Just do it with sunflower oil because you want a nice hot temperature. So oxtail going in, seasoned flour into the oil. We want to get a nice color on the oxtail. And then we want to take it out. We want to take the oxtail out and put it on. What do you think of my new uniform, ladies and gentlemen? Look, I got to say thank you to Greg at Wolf Showroom in Knightsbridge. He gave me this apron because Wolf are happily sponsoring me. They've given me all this lovely equipment to cook with. Oh, I don't know what to do. Thank you, Greg. And by the way, I want a leather apron. I don't want the cotton one, I want a leather one. Yes, Greg. So, here we go. We're seasoning the oxtail. Get nice color, maximum heat, 5,000 watts of power here. So what I'm gonna do, we're gonna seal the oxtail, get it a bit of color. I'm gonna put it on the side, and I'm gonna come back to you with the next stage, because then we take the meat out and we do the vegetables. Back in a minute. Right, next stage. I've changed the pan, I've put a bigger pan because there wasn't enough room for the oxtail. So we're doing oxtail stew. We've browned the oxtail. What you want to do is you want to make sure you brown it, because on the outside of the oxtail, there's a lot of fat. So you want to get rid of all that fat, otherwise you're going to get a fatty stew. So we're getting this really nice and brown. The oxtail, really nice color. Look at the color on that. So what we're going to do is we're going to take that oxtail out and do the next stage. Pay attention, next stage. Now what we want to do, take the oxtail out. Am I doing that fast enough? Yes, I am. Take the oxtail out, next stage. Watch carefully. There's a lot of oil in here, sunflower oil, good for frying, but not good for eating. So what we're gonna do is take the oil out. We don't want this oil. Chuck it in the sink, right. So we've just got the bits of meat there. We're gonna go with the garlic, onion. Keep it on maximum heat. Sizzle, sizzle. Sizzle, sizzle, John. That's what we want. Sizzle, sizzle. Bit of salt, carrots. I'll give you the measurements later. Leeks, leeks, celery. Right, that's gonna sweat down. Right, bit of thyme. Yes. Oh, what time is it, Mr. Wolf? Mr. Wolf, what time is it? Yes, bit of thyme. Right, lovely. Oh, the smell. Oh, this is the thyme that I grow in my garden. I leave it in the sun, I dry it, I pick it, and voila, there you go. A bit of ground. You see, that's all starting to sweat down now. I might have to come back. A bit, a teaspoon of ground caraway seed. Right, here we go. Just a little teaspoon ground caraway seed. Right, that's all coming together. Right, then we're gonna do brandy, then we're gonna do red wine. I'm gonna cut away because I was told my videos are too long, so I'm gonna sweat this down, come back to you when it's time for the brandy, and then cut away, come back to you when it's time for the red wine. See you in a minute. I'm gonna have some more of this super duper Red Bull. Take care. All right, am I going too fast? Next stage, we sweated down celery, onions, carrots, leeks. We sweated all that down, garlic. Now we're gonna do a little bit of brandy, Remy Martin VSOP. Make sure it's nice and dry so you get that sizzle when you put the brandy. Can you hear? Sizzle, sizzle, brandy. Let that evaporate. Then we've got, that's gonna evaporate now. Then we've got red wine. And to do, see how quick that brandy has evaporated. Yes, oh, let's have some more. Let's have some more brandy, yes. Here we go, right. So this is lovely restaurant, Tragada, Tragada in Ronda. I know my friend who works there, he's the head chef. What is his name? Paco, Paco, yes. Anyway, so we've got the onion, celery, garlic, carrots. We've just added the brandy. We've got the seared oxtail here. We've taken away the oil so it's nice and clean, nice and healthy. We've got the beef stock here, the red wine. So here we go, in with the red wine. Now this is about half a bottle of red wine. Now that's got to simmer down, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, cats and dogs. That's got to simmer down. I'm gonna come back to you when that's simmered down. See you in a minute. Okay, we're back. So the red wine has gone down to a syrup. That's what we want. We want a nice syrup. So we've got the vegetables in the syrupy red wine. Now I'm gonna change the pot now because this is a very flat, wide pan, and I was doing this just so you could see. You could see, there you go. So now I'm gonna do it in a nice pot with a lid. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna put the oxtail in the pot. Put the oxtail in the pot, right? And all the juices, get all the juices, right? I'm gonna put the oxtail in the pot, right? And then what have we got here? We've got the vegetables and the red wine, which has boiled down now to a syrup, and all the vegetables have sucked up all the wine. We need the vegetables to suck good, suck the wine up and absorb, because you don't want the wine to evaporate. You want them to go into the vegetables. So that's why you need to simmer to a syrup. Right, so now, what are we gonna do? We're gonna put the vegetables in the pot. So we've got the oxtail here in the pot. We're gonna put the vegetables in. Here we go. Sorry, I can't do this facing you, it's too heavy. Right. So we put the vegetables in. Right, did I spill some? Yes, one carrot. Right, now we've got the oxtail in there, which has been sealed. We've got the vegetables, we've got the red wine syrup. Sizzle, sizzle. Can you hear? Yes, sizzle, sizzle. Now we put the beef stock. Beef stock, just use normal stock cubes. I like oxo. Oxo is good, oxo is good. Right, so beef stock, here we go. Right, and now put the beef stock. You want to cover for 40 minutes and leave it. Come back to it in 40 minutes and then I'll get on to the next step. Back in a minute. Okay, so where are we? We're back. We've done the beef stock in the oxtail. We simmered it for between 40 minutes and an hour. I've made some potatoes. I'm going to do some nice puree potatoes. This is very simple. You rice the potatoes, put some butter, some milk, some salt, some white pepper, and there you go, puree potatoes. Very easy to do. You can do it with butter, you can do it with the milk, you can do it with olive oil and garlic. or garlic infused olive oil, whichever way you want. Pom puree or mashed potato. Right, so we've got the oxtail. They've been stewing in here for about an hour. And next step is to emulsify the sauce, to puree the sauce. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the oxtail out and we're gonna blend the sauce with my little stick blender here, my little Braun Turbo stick blender. So first of all, we've got to take the oxtail out because we don't wanna blend the bones. No, we don't. Right, so here we go. I'm gonna use this implement, which is called a spider. So the spider takes the meat out without the liquid. Right, so we're gonna take, I'll be as quick as possible, take the meat out, make sure it's all out. The oxtail, look how it's nice and tender, but this is stage one. So what we're gonna do is, we're gonna take the oxtail out, we're gonna blend the sauce, the stew, blend the vegetables, and then we're gonna put the oxtail back inside to cook a further hour. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. So take the oxtail out. So we're just left with the sauce and the vegetables. So we take the oxtail out. You see, it's all out now. Oh, well, that one's still alive. Right, take the oxtail out. So what do we got here? So what we do is you blend the sauce now with a stick blender. Now, if you want a nice, thick, hearty sauce, you can just blend it, put the oxtail back inside, cook it another hour. Some chefs, they want to do fancy schmancy. They blend the sauce, they pass it through a chinoise like this, then they put it back in the pot, and they put the oxtail in. I'm gonna pass it through the chinoise, because I'm a chef and I'm fancy schmancy. Anyway, so I'm gonna blend it now with my stick blender, then I'm gonna pass it through the chinoise, very easy. So if there's any like bits of thyme that you don't want to have it in between your teeth, that will all come out. So now I'm blending it, right? I need a couple of minutes for that because I want to blend it properly. You see, it's doing an amazing job. Just blend. Oh, I think there was an oxtail in there. Yes, I discovered another oxtail. Where is it, you bugger? Come on. Where is it? I heard it. That's why you need to sieve it. There it is, the critter, the last bit of oxtail. Right, so we're gonna blend this like this. Right, look at that. We're gonna blend this. Nice sauce. Right, I'm gonna blend it. I'm gonna pass it through the chinoise, and I'm gonna put the oxtail back inside. I'm gonna simmer it for another hour. Back in a minute. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so we're on the last bit now. We've got the nice mashed potato there, pom puree, potato, butter, milk. Turn that off. So we've got the lovely oxtail that's been stewing in the sauce. Remember, we took the oxtail out, we blitzed the sauce with the blender, we put the oxtail back in, then we cooked it for about another hour. That timing depends on the oxtail. If it's a good tender meat, it'll cook quicker. If it's slightly tougher, it'll take longer. So you just want to take a piece of oxtail out and just cut a little piece off the side of it and just give it a little taste. If it's still a bit chewy, put it back in. This is oxtail. It's low, long and slow. Long and slow, baby. Long and slow. Right, so what we're going to do, this is ready now. This has been actually cooking for about 2 hours. And the sauce is ready because it's talking to me. The sauce is talking to me. It's going bloop, bloop, bloop. So that means it's ready. It's a nice thick sauce. It's not too runny and it's not too thick. It's just like a bolognese, you know, just going bloop, bloop, bloop. Anyway, so we're gonna do presentation now on the plate. Oxtail stew with pom puree. So we don't need this. We're gonna do a little quenelle of potato. Let's see if I can do the quenelle. Yeah, I still got it. He's still got it. Yes, he's still got it. That's too much. Too much. This is called a quenelle. I'll do two quenelles. Yes. Ha ha ha. I bet you thought I couldn't do that. Here we go, another one. Cornell, Cornell. I learned this at Cordon Bleu. Two Cornell. Look at that. Right, so there we go. We've got two Cornells. Right, now we're going to get a nice bit of oxtail. You want to use the thick part of the tail, all the little tiny bits from the end of the tail, that's just to flavour the sauce. So you want a nice thick piece. And as you break it with the fork, the meat's just going to fall off the bone. That's a nice piece. Oxtail. Let's get another big, fat, juicy piece. Yes. Here's a nice big piece. You can see the bone in the middle here. Oh, turn it up, turn it up. This is a hearty winter stew. Not for summer. We're not in Beverly Hills now. This is a hearty Surrey winter stew. So, let me clean this up a little bit. Then we put the sauce. Lovely sauce. Oxtail stew with pomme puree. Look at that, nice shiny sauce. Oh, fantastic. Now that meat, you can just pick it off the bone with a fork. Nice hearty stew. Look at that. Fantastic, fantastic. I'm amazing. I'm amazing. Right, if you want, you could do a little bit of garnish. Little bit of garnish. Little bit of parsley. Now this is from lovely restaurant in Rondo. They do have a Michelin star. I got the recipe from the head chef. Maybe I stole it, maybe I didn't. Anyway, oxtail stew, lovely winter pomme puree. I'm gonna show you a close up in a minute. See you next time. Thank you very much. Ciao.